But faith is. Not faith is going to be, but faith is. And first of all, what we must understand about faith, it is a thing that has no past, nor present, nor future. But faith exists in the now. And I have to get you to understand that, because sometimes we lack in our spiritual fortitude because we're looking for a future faith. And we're living on the past faith. Mm-hmm. But the faith that matters is the faith that you have right now.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. And understanding that the Bible describes unto us that without faith,
it's impossible.
It is impossible
to please God.
To please God. As a matter of fact, as we're getting more intimate in this word, you cannot even approach God without faith.
No, you can't.
Because it says, he that cometh to God must do it first, believe that he is God. So you cannot even approach God if you approach him without faith. It is a necessary means by what you will enter into the presence of God is with faith. Mm-hmm. No faith, you cannot approach him.
No, you can't.
But with faith, you can walk boldly to the throne of grace to get some help when you need it, and grace to help in the time of need. Mm-hmm. So when we understand all of those things, we understand why the Apostle Paul said in the 11th chapter, now faith. Faith must be approached with a sense of urgency. Now. Not tomorrow, but now. Not next week, but right now. I choose to believe God despite of my situation, and I choose to believe him right now. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm not going to wait until I get a good report from the physician, but I'm going to believe God now. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Does anybody know what I'm talking about tonight? Hallelujah. So when you understand his definition, he was saying that right now, in the midst of whatever it is that you're in, you can choose to believe God or you can choose to believe something else. But I don't know about y'all, but I choose to believe God, and I choose to believe him right now.
That's right.
This is why David said that he is a very present help. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. In the time of storm, now faith is. And you must understand this thing. And I'm just telling you what God laid on my heart today. It is not something that you approach systematically. And that's the problem that I have with churches and preachers all over America, because they want to approach everything systematically. They want to give you 7 steps to get your miracle, 3 steps to get your breakthrough, and 5 steps to get you a man or a woman. Nothing that God does happens systematically. Everything that God does, he does it of his own will and of his own accord. So it really degrades the church. What do you mean, Pastor, when you say degrade? Because somebody's going to say, Pastor, I done did the 3 steps and I still haven't got my miracle. It will cause somebody to walk out of church because you made this belief in God a system. And in effect, it's not a system. It's not something that you can be taught. You just have to believe God. Walk in his word, walk in his will, walk in his way, and say, Lord, whatever your will is.
Be done.
Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Now, faith is. When you understand just those 3 words, then it says it is the substance
spiritual things.
What does he mean by substance? It is the sustaining force of all creation. Everything that is in existence today came through faith. We'll go into this later on. Hebrews, it says, by faith the worlds were framed. That means the universe was created by faith. And it is the substance. It is the substance. It is the formulative formula of the things that we need to understand God himself. And quite frankly, we'll never truly understand God, but understand him to our ability or our capability that God is an awesome God. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. In other words, faith is the thing that gives credence to the Word of God. If you do not or cannot believe the Word of God, then quite simply, there's a challenge for you to believe God. But when you believe the Word of God, then you, amen, are walking in faith. We as Christian believers have no grounds to stand on our own faculties. But when we stand on the thing that was left for us, what are you standing on? I'm standing on the Word that was left for me. That when everything that's around me goes down, I'll still be standing there on the Word of God.
That's right.
What do you mean, Pastor? Before one jot or tittle of his word shall fail, heaven and earth will pass away.
Yes, it will.
And we must understand and learn if we're going to walk in faith, we're going to walk in the Word of God. Stand on the Word of God by faith. Amen. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. By mere virtue of you believing, that's the evidence that there's some things that you cannot see. There's evidence of some things that you don't understand. But because you stand in faith, because you stand in what you know of God, he reveals himself to you day by day. And I hope you understand this, amen. You wouldn't even understand the revelation of God if you didn't have faith.
Yes.
When things begin to go on in your life and you cannot understand it, amen, just look in faith and say, well, God is trying to tell me something, amen. And it is through this faith that we have, amen, the belief that we need necessary to walk in God. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Look at verse number 6 in the 11th chapter. Verse number 6 in the 11th chapter of Hebrews. It says, but without faith, it is what?
Impossible.
Impossible to please him.
That's right.
Before we go any further, if there is an impossibility to please him without faith, that means with faith, you please God. Oh, amen. I don't even know if y'all understand that. Hallelujah. Because sometimes we go around thinking, if I do this and if I do that and if I go here and I go that, but all you need to please God is faith. Faith causes your walk to straighten up. Faith causes your life to straighten up.
Yes, it does.
Faith causes your walk, amen, to be closer to God. And he says, but without faith, it is
impossible
to please him. Then it says in verse number 6, for he that what cometh to God must believe that he is. That he's what? That he's God. What do you mean by that? That he's God. That no problem that you have is too great that he cannot solve. No sickness in your body, no disease, no infirmity, no situation is too difficult. Why? Because he is God. And if you understand that he's God, you won't worry about the things that you're in. Now, faith. Now, look what it says right here. For he that cometh to God must believe.
I ain't nothing but